Google images like these can give you a lot of information about people's wealth. The whole planet has been captured in detail by satellites orbiting the Earth. Now, Togo is using these images in new ways to get cash to people affected by COVID-19. In April 2020, Togo introduced curfews and lockdowns to control the spread of coronavirus. But the measures designed to protect people's health also affected their earnings.
With the coronavirus pandemic, my business has been hit hard because people from the cities haven't been able to travel here to buy our produce.
So the government knew it needed to send money to some of its citizens, but how could they target the right people?
We heard about what the UC Berkeley team was doing in terms of using satellite imagery for poverty maps. So we reached out to them saying, guys, we need to have a poverty map of Togo. We have an Institute of Statistics that can make, you know, survey on the ground, but we need some kind of a short way, a very quick and effective way to have a poverty map.
The team at Berkeley had been building these poverty maps from survey data and satellite images.
Intuitively, when a person looks at an image, like even an aerial image of their house or of a village in Africa, there are clear signals of some places being wealthier than others. Things like the quality of the roofing material, or the density of the houses, or the size of the plots of land, or the quality of road construction, or even just like how much of a clean sense of urban planning there is in the region you're looking at.
A computer algorithm then interprets this data to make a poverty map.
So in this interface, poverty is indicated by low height extrusions and blue and white coloring. The more you zoom in, the more granular the estimates get, up until the point where each single grid cell represents just a 2 kilometer region.
They worked with the government to put Togo's data on a map. It identified Fiata as one of the poorest regions in the country. Next, they had to find out which individuals there needed cash. To do that, they analysed mobile phone records, which can give a good estimate of someone's wealth. The Berkeley team worked out who was vulnerable and gave that information to the government.
Diseases and the lockdown means we can no longer leave our village to sell products in the market.
Gamay makes hair products, like this hair dye. With less money coming in, she decided to apply.
I heard about it on radio, so I gave my voter's card to my husband, who was able to access the platform on his mobile phone. The money has allowed us to pay our children's school fees.
The money is sent to people's phones and can later be withdrawn as cash. So the system reduces contact between people and limits the spread of the virus. Each month for 5 months, women get $15 and men get 13. The idea is to help households. The government arranges the payments, but the money itself is donated by a charity called Give Directly.
The money that I receive each month has been a great help, and yet I couldn't believe it when we were told that we could get this help from our little phones.
So far, 35,000 Togolese people have benefited from this scheme, and there are plans to triple that number in the next few months.